I've been thinking recently about some of the games I've played over the past few years that really stuck with me. Among this sea of normality and compromise that's constantly released, there's always ones that shine through. Looking back, I think a year that had three of these titles was 2017. One of these, Persona 5, I had already planned on getting, and in fact clocked over 100 hours into it. And while it's definitely not perfect, I'd be lying if I said I didn't have a good time. The other two kind of flew under my radar, one of these being Yakuza 0, as until that game, I'd yet to experience the Yakuza series, only to find once I did, I'd be kicking myself for not getting into it sooner. But the second was perhaps the most surprising, NieR Automata. Hi guys, I'm Mike, and welcome to the Lion's Lounge, where today we're going to be talking about this fantastic game. NieR Automata is an action RPG developed by Platinum Games, the same developers of the Bayonetta series, and more recently Astral Chain, and was created and directed by Yoko Taro. It serves as a sequel to one of the multiple endings of the original NieR, itself a spin-off of the Drakengard series, in particular an ending of Drakengard 1. And if this is all new to you and you're starting to get confused already, don't worry, I'm not going to be diving into any of this. But if you are interested in the lore behind NieR Automata and the games it was spun off from, check out Clem's channel as he goes into great detail on all of the Drakengard games, NieR and NieR Automata. It's also worth noting that you do not need to have any prior knowledge of any of the previous games to play NieR Automata. The game does make callbacks and features characters from NieR, but I can tell you as someone who went to this cold myself, you'll still be able to get a great deal of enjoyment out of it. Automata takes place in a post-apocalyptic version of Earth in the far future, where humans have migrated to the moon and have created a faction of autonomous androids to fight a proxy war in their stead with machines developed by aliens hoping to claim the planet for their own. Like the Drakengard series and NieR, the game has multiple endings, each of which must be completed to continue the story. Though in the case of Automata, you play as three different androids in these routes, and from them glean more information on these characters' thoughts and motivations, as well as the world as a whole. These characters being 2B, 9S, and A2, all of which are extremely distinct not just in their character designs, but in their personalities as well. Without really spoiling anything, the main themes of NieR Automata revolve around what being human really means, and whether the androids and machines act as they do because they are gaining free will, or because they're simply trying to emulate emotions of the humans that created them. Like Taro's other works, it gets really philosophical, really deep, and really dark. And it's this tone combined with a spectacular gameplay and incredible soundtrack that really hit me hard. I mean, it's been 3 years since I first played the game and I'm still thinking about it. Among the many side characters you encounter throughout the game are the twins Devola and Popola. These two are introduced in the first part and play a more prominent role in 9S and A2 stories. And as stated before, Automata is a sequel to NieR, where there are also androids called Devola and Popola. While they do play a minor role here, primarily aiding 9S, their backstory is expanded throughout the game, which also helps the greater tie it into its prequel. And oh boy, it's a story. Today's drink is inspired by an item received in a side quest called The Twins' Request, which once completed, Devola and Popola give A2. The item is called Popola's Booze and functions as a temporary buff to your character, increasing attack strength and restoring health. You also learn that Popola makes it herself from desert roses and is a favorite of Devola's. With this cocktail, I wanted to incorporate rose flavoring, which you can do so by adding rose water. Very potent, so you're gonna definitely wanna use this sparingly. So to make this, you're gonna first want some simple syrup. As usual, this is a 2-to-1 simple syrup, and you're gonna want 1/2 ounce or 15 milliliters. Next, 1.5 ounces or 45 milliliters of lime juice. Next, 1.5 ounces or 45 milliliters of Saint Germain. This is an elderflower liqueur. Then 2 ounces or 60 milliliters of gin. And lastly, just 1/2 bar spoon of rose water. I'd really recommend you be careful with this, as if you use too much, it's going to overpower the rest of the drink. Add some ice to your tin and give it a shake. Then strain into a Nick and Nora glass or a coupe. And for garnish, I'm going to use these dried rose petals. They are typically used in teas or baking, so they are edible. And with that, you have Popola's Booze. Let's try it out. This drink is really surprising in terms of how it tastes. When I first stumbled upon the recipe and saw it featured rose water, I was extremely hesitant, mainly because I got curious on what rose water actually tastes like, And I tried it by itself. It's bad. It's really bad. Don't try it. It's gross. It's what you'd expect. It's extremely floral. It smells like roses. It tastes very strongly of roses, which is why I say you should really be careful on how much you use in your drink. But in this case, the ingredients really mesh with each other. The London Dry Gin has a lot of botanicals combined with the elderflower liqueur, that Saint Germain, and the rose water. But what does this actually taste like? It's like a lemon drop martini, but with some floral notes on the back end that actually are pretty good. Would I make this again? Probably. If you want to get some rose water, it is kind of difficult to find, but you can order on Amazon, which is what I did, and it's like 10 bucks. I'll make sure to link which one I got in the description below. And then all you really need is the gin and the Saint Germain and some lime juice. So yeah, very surprising and really good. Today's drink was Popola's Booze, based on an item of the same name in NieR Automata. If you like this video and want to see more, please like and subscribe. If you have any drinks you'd like me to make, please let me know in the comments below. If you want to see what I make outside these videos, follow me on Twitter at Mr. Space Lion. Or Instagram at Mr. Space Lion. I'm Mike, and thank you so much for stopping by the Lion's Lounge. I hope to see you next time.